talking about our Chattanooga game. Thought we started off aggressive defensively, which got us the early lead. Really played into the game plan. We had challenged our perimeter to step up and really try to force turnovers to create easy scoring opportunities, which we did early. The ball movement was great. We didn't get the ball stuck in our hands. We played through our post, which is vital. Our post is, they're playing extremely well right now with Mercedes and Bashara. Now we just have to learn to sustain that type of energy and intensity level for 40 minutes after the first quarter. We became a little lax, start taking quick shots, turning the ball over. So that's some issues that we will address today when we start practice. But we have a great test on Friday with Albany. Coach Katie Abrahamson is a great coach. Her team is scrappy. They play hard. A year ago, they had a great game against Duke in the NCAA tournament. They will not back down. They will come to this gym ready to play, and we have to be ready to work on. We have to be ready to match their intensity.
Hi, Coach. Albany's got two girls that can score a lot in a variety of different ways. I know you haven't shown the team film of them yet, I guess they said, but what will you tell them about those two players in particular?
You know, we've really challenged our team this year. We want to take our opponent's best scorers and limit them to under their average or cut it in half. Obviously, we'll try to limit their touches. The less time they have the ball in their hands, the less time they can score. You know, Coach Law did the scout. We will game plan them. We will look to trap and force turnovers and get the ball out of their hands as much as possible.
Coach, with Bashara being named the SEC Co-Player of the Week, what has she done so well this season?
Her mindset has changed. Her sense of urgency is through the roof right now. She's playing extremely confident. You know, Coach Holly came to her, told her, like, this team needs you to step up, lead by example, play hard, play with emotion, play with passion, and she has done that not only in games but in practice.
Speaking of that mindset, she's kind of got the mindset to dominate this year, and she even mentioned after the game that this team wants to dominate. Do you talk to this team about those 40 minutes and having the intensity? They kind of said they backed off a little bit, they thought.
We do. We talk often about just, you know, winning, setting the tone, making a statement, you know, playing like Lady Vol basketball teams are capable of playing. So every game, every practice, we want that type of intensity. Obviously, we did not sustain it. We are a work in progress, but it's still early in the season, and we will continue to get better.
Kyra, I wanted to ask you a little bit more about Albany. There seems to be more and more teams like them, kind of mid-major types that are really emerging as really dangerous opponents. What do you see that's happening that's allowing for these schools to become like this now?
Well, every opponent is dangerous, but you know, I think mid-major schools, they have kids that are hungry. They want to play hard. You know, they're very coachable, and they're willing to do the extra work, and that's making their teams exceptional.
Coach, is there anything that you guys can do as a coaching staff to make sure the team maintains the intensity for all 40 minutes, or is that just on the players?
Well, it's on both. You know, Holly had talked to the girls about playing hard. There's a few things that she's looking for. She wants us to play pressure defense. You must play hard, sprint the floor, rebounding, and she just kind of told them, if they don't do those things, you will come out of the game. And I think you saw she subbed five people out, put five new in. So that is the standard that she has set, and she will set the tone because most players want to play. So she does have the ability to control that. But, you know, our players have to have the heart and passion to want to do it, and which for the most part they do.
Were you expecting this kind of, I mean, were you expecting there to be an adjustment process going in terms of trying to find the right combinations that will work on the floor because of all the pieces that left, pieces coming in, or has it been a little bit more of an adjustment than you thought?
No, it has been an adjustment. You know, we haven't had everyone healthy all at one time. We started the first game with six people, then we added three more people. So the combinations, we're still trying to see which combination works on the floor, who plays the best together, and we're still, you know, getting people back. So the combinations won't be set just yet. But good thing it is still early, and we will work through those kinks.
Coach, can you evaluate Taya Cooper as a freshman point guard these first four games, what she's doing well and what you need to see her get better at?
Taya's playing exceptionally well for a freshman. She's extremely talented. Her strong point is, one, her mindset. She wants to win. She's competitive. Two, her ability to score the basketball. I mean, she can get to the rim. She's great in transition. She can shoot the ball. Now, the things that she needs to work on, being able to control tempo, time and possession, defensively, staying between her man and the ball without fouling. And when she picks up a certain amount of fouls, knowing when to back off and when to adjust. So she's still learning that part of the game. But for a freshman, she's doing really well.
Kerry, you guys are trying to or want to press more this year. How much of an adjustment is that going to be for these guys? Because that's a real effort thing. And I mean, is that still something that they're getting used to or not, do you feel like?
I don't know if it's something that they're getting used to. I think just when we get all the pieces and we have everyone, you know, to make it different, you want to play up-tempo. You have to be able to sub when you play up-tempo because you're asking them to play all out with the style that we're playing. We're asking them to pressure the ball, crash the boards offensively, run an up-tempo offense. So just getting everyone back in the groove and playing with each other and the type of shape that we need to be in to play, but we'll get there.
We're seeing probably only a slice of what Diamond can really do. How much better can Diamond get as the season goes on?
You know, Diamond has the chance to really be great. Her talent is exceptional. Her basketball IQ, she has a very high one. Right now, she's still trying to get her feet wet, let the game come back to her. She hadn't played in over a year, trying to learn her teammates, trying to adjust to Holly's system here. So it's been a lot for her. But I thought in the last game, she really started to play more confidently offensively and trusting her leg that she's able to go. So the sky's the limit for her, and we look forward to seeing what she can do in the future.
It's kind of building off that. What's been the biggest adjustment to Holly's system for Diamond? And then with the three-point shooting, you have a very offensive-minded ball club. I'm sure the mentality is still there to put up the shots.
That's a good way to put it. Yes, we are very offensive-minded, which is good. You have to put points on the board. We will continue to work as a staff of executing in the half court. Right now we're shooting the ball too quick, making unforced turnovers, which is limiting some of our possessions, and just settle in offensively. We want to play through our posts. Mercedes is playing well. Bashar is playing well, which we touched on. And people are packing it in on us. They're playing zone. But we still tell the girls, you still have to go through the post. They might not get the shot, but once they suck in everyone, let us kick out. And then the guards are just going to have to get confident and put the ball in the basket. We have capable scorers. I think it's, you know, now it's a snowball effect. We've missed a couple of shots. Now everybody's like, oh, we can't hit shots. We can hit shots. We'll go back in the gym, get extra shots with our girls, and you'll see improvement. Thank you.